Coming up, this is 1:15, and they're at a family reunion looking out at the farm place. Herschel and his son, Grandpa Massey, and my mother. The lady with the Peter Pan collar has her child. And there's a man with a receding hairline in the back. That might have been not Uncle Jim, because I don't think he and his wife had any children. Hobart, Walter, Herschel, and Jim. Maybe that is Uncle Jim. At any rate, Anna Mae is got on an apron, and she has on an apron in several of these pictures. I'm pretty sure that's who she is. Grandma Massey is standing at the back of the table, and there's some man peeping behind his kid's head that I don't know. I don't know the people on the right of that picture. Here again, I'm pretty sure that June Allison will know who they are. Well, this is a big spread on the sawhorse table. Looks like they've got a grinding stone here and a sharpening stone here in the front. Model T Ford in the back, and that's the tree that it was parked under, and they took all the pictures under that tree also. They've got lots of goodies on that table. Looks like it would be about 3 tablecloths long. And a plowed field in the background. Obviously, the home place. And this is Martha Evelyn and Thomas Earle and Mary Florence standing on the running board of a Model A Ford with, what do you call that? Not swamp grass, that stuff that hangs out of trees in Florida.
Spanish moss.
And June said, when she was talking to me on the phone, that the one with the tree with the Spanish moss was made in Jacksonville, Florida at Uncle Jim's home. So evidently we visited in Jacksonville. This is 1:20. Must be all the men in that family. See if I can find one that looks like my dad. No, but it's a bunch of young men, overalls and work clothes, and one of them looks like he's got on a knee breeches. I'm pretty sure that's Uncle Herschel, but that I've been identifying the woman in the black dress with a scoop neck is my mother, and I don't know why she would be in the picture with Grandma and Uncle Herschel. So I have no explanation for that. Oh, this is 1:23 right now, and it's my mother and a baby. She's got on a checkered dress. And I guess that's Thomas Earle and myself and Maria Florence sitting on a bench that's made out of sticks of wood. I don't know where that was taken, but sure looks like us. And that's Gladys reaching up to get a orange off of an orange tree. She must have gone to Florida with us. My mother, Hobart, and me, and Thomas Searle, maybe as a baby. And I think we're standing by the side of the road on the way to between McMinnville and when we would go to Chattanooga. I always got car sick, so we always had to stop somewhere for me to throw up and get my bearings. So that may be where that was made. Hobart Junior's got on overalls. I finally found out that looking out the window was what was making me so sick, so I used to get on the floor and just put my head down on the back seat so I would not look out the window, and I could go all the way between McMinnville and Chattanooga without throwing up. And that's the same group, only we're just sitting on the rock and mother's there at the side. Okay, this is 132, and it's mother without her glasses sitting and holding the baby. And 133. My gosh, is that kid's head bleeding or what? Anyway, he's got a smile on his face, whoever he is, but it looks like his head's bleeding and it's running down his nose. Probably not. Mother and the baby. And a baby and a Model T. Wherever, the baby's on the ground behind the car. Strange place to put him. I think this is a picture of me in a little red wagon. I think that was identified by somebody else, told me that was me. I'm frowning for some reason. And this is that same flat rock where we, the throw up rock. It's Granddaddy, Hobart Jr., myself, and obviously Tommy, Thomas Earl. Oh, I've got on my Mary Jane shoes. Used to polish my shoes I loved them so much. And they came up and had three places to button over on them. And you polished, they were patent leather. These are white. They were patent leather, and you polished them with the inside of a banana peeling. I'd sit on the front steps and polish my shoes. I love that. This looks like Gladys and Thomas Earl sitting under a tree in Florida. And I'm going by the trunk of the tree. Looks like it's a palm tree that the fronds have been cut off of. And this is Hobart Massey with a string of fish. He loved to fish. This is 143, and looks like Thomas Earl picking an orange, and Florence picking an orange, and some lady that worked for my grandparents, a black lady that worked for my grandparents, holding Florence up where she could get one. Granddaddy. Yeah, I guess that's Granddaddy Massey with that same string of fish. They must have been all winners. Come on. A young boy with that same stringer of fish. I don't know who he is. He looks like more like my Uncle Tommy. Might have looked at that age, but I don't know who he is. Some man I don't know with the same stringer of fish. They must have gone collectively to get them. same stringer of fish, but that doesn't look like my daddy's mouth. Don't know who he is. Stringer of fish on the line. On the fence. In the little sailor suit, that's Thomas Earl. I don't know what kind of socks they've got on that kid. Looks like bandages. He didn't wear bandages. He and I were the two middle children.